The ship's ready to sail. Where are you headed?
We don't have a problem. If you've got a grudge, we can settle it here and now.
Huh? Why would we have a grudge against you guys? The first mate fought like the first mate. The captain died like the captain, right?
I suppose.
Then no swabby here can blame you for what happened. We're Ifrid's pirates, and don't forget it. We're not so pathetic that we need pity from some lord of calamity.
All right. The ship's in your hands.
Aye, aye. You can count on us.
The Von Eltia looks the same as ever. But it feels utterly different, doesn't it?
Yeah. Even Benwick looked like he'd been crying.
I can imagine. But if we let ourselves despair now, we'd be a disgrace to Ifrid's creed.
We have to swallow our anger and grief, and sail on.
Right. Following a creed isn't always pleasant. We must do what we must.
I won't allow the Abbey to do things like this.
Destroying someone like that, turning them into a puppet, it's unconscionable.
Still, a heart can never be fully bridled. It can be shattered, but never erased entirely.
Ifrid proved that.
Right. His body is gone, but he lives on through his crew. Magilu is right. What lives in one's heart can never be erased.
Yeah. The heart is eternal.
So, it was Innominant who did it, but I think Shigure could have done the same.
So hardness alone isn't enough. Forgive me. I thought I had found clarity, but it was only foolish pride.
You should be proud. You are, without a doubt, the greatest swordsmith in the world. I'm looking forward to your next blade.
Even now, you would still place your trust in me.
Of course. Is there any other swordsmith who could craft a blade out of orichalcum? You're a master of your art, a visionary who spent centuries working to forge a blade of legend. I'm honored to know you.
I don't know what to say.
Unless, of course, you've given up on making a sword to surpass Stormhowl.
Does this look like the face of a man who's given up?
Not in the least.
We're making good time.
The only problem is that ceremony that Arturius was going on about. We don't know how long it'll take.
Ifrid said they called it the Ceremony of Suppression. Most likely, it's how Innominant plans to release his power.
Most likely. He hasn't absorbed Lafayette in your despair, so Innominant should still be incomplete. But if his powers fully awaken...
humanity will be robbed of their free will!
I can hear them celebrating now. The uglinesses of the human soul are suppressed! And the world is free of malevolence! Hurrah! Hurrah!
Robbing humanity of its will. They'll be like I once was.
Something's coming!
Hey, please, guys, let's not fight!
This is a domain?
Innominant's domain!
Their wills have been stolen!
It's not been fully sealed away yet. Rokuro, give him a good smacking! Wake him up!
On it!
Aizen!
Got it. We'll put in at the nearest harbor. To Port Zexen!
Ah! I feel like some jerk played tug of war with my brain.
Dig up some spirit. They're trying to strip away your will.
You're all right.
I do not deserve to be all right. I used people, stepped on them just to make a profit. I even aided wanted criminals so that I could expand my business. My soul is black with ugliness and can never be forgiven.
No, wait! Stop!
The world needs to be purified of malevolence. I don't belong here. I have to die. I have to die. I have to die.
No, it's not right! Ugh.
You can die if you want. But saying you have to die is a good way to make my blood boil.
Those awakened to their own malevolence seek to end their lives. Welcome to Artorias' uncompromising world of reason.
First they steal humanity's rudder, and now they want to say who lives and who dies?
We should find out what's happening here, unless you'd rather not see.
You're right. I wouldn't. But I won't hide from the truth any longer.
Before anything else, we'll need to confirm just how far his power reaches. Let's head to Logris.
Innominant suppression. Is this the ideal world the Abbey envisions?
There's no life in anyone's eyes! This isn't a fun place at all!
It's not just people's minds being shackled. They're being forced to die, too. It's terrible.
Why would dying be part of anyone's ideal world?
Even under such strict control, new sins can still rise to the surface. If that happens, it's better to end the life of the sinner. Melchior came to the same logical conclusion.
What utter rubbish.
Anyway, we need to get to Logris.
What's going to happen to the world? How far will Innominant's power spread?
When his domain expanded, I felt a faraway power suddenly come closer. It was enough to blot out the whole sky. I'm sure it's covered other towns, too.
His domain has certainly extended to at least the entire populace of this country. Otherwise, what would be the point?
That means what happened at Port Zexen is happening everywhere.
Everyone is either a puppet or
dead by their own hands.
Innominant created this ideal hell in a single moment. That's the power we're up against.
So we few are standing against a truly monumental force.
This is your last chance to turn back.
Turn back to what exactly?
Forward or back? We're headed into hell either way.
At least this way, I'll have my own free will. I'd prefer a living damnation to that oblivion.
Well, don't come crying to me later.
Let's move along then.
So this is the result of their ceremony of suppression.
Seems that way. They've brought their peace to mankind.
I was a fool for trying to sell commemorative chalices to the people visiting the Empyrean's throne.
Happiness can't be bought with ill-gotten gains made through deception. In an effort to change my malevolent ways, I sold my shop and entered the holy priesthood. Rather than pursue my own greed, I've chosen to dedicate my life to bringing the sacred teachings to all.
Wow, look how shiny and pure he is. So this is what happens when Innominant suppresses all of someone's sins and desires.
How nauseating. And this is the kind of world they're trying to create.
Hey, you're Kakiku's menagerie.
Ooh, close. It's Magilu's menagerie.
I apologize for always demanding that you entertain me, despite my inability to even remember your name correctly. I'm also sorry to you, miss, for always insisting you do that tedious little bird impression of yours. I feel so bad I could just punch myself. Nay, I must!
I'm not sure if I'm more angry or confused.
It is wrong to seek pleasure from viewing petty tricks and pointless entertainment. Honest hard work alone is right. Someone such as I, who was unable to live in accordance to the simplest of truths, should disappear from this earth. Please, use that special trick you told me of. Make me disappear forever.
Worth killing.
Watch yourselves.
Killing flash.
But I'm this close.
I want this. Form zero. Thunder.
This fight is over.
I must accept that we all grow old. I can no longer perform the physical labor that allowed me to benefit society. I no longer deserve to live here. I must find a place far from others. There, I will await a quiet death.
This isn't someone accepting that they'll grow old. This is him refusing to grow old.
If this spreads, we'll have no more old people at all.
Pets consume precious resources and grant no tangible benefit to society. That's why I say we should throw them all back outside. It's only right.
I threw away my friend's entire pet beetle collection. They have been purged. This is all for the new order.
But I want to keep my rhino stagros.
It was the height of foolishness for a low-born person like me to hold on to romantic fantasies about Prince Percival. I should seek a male companion suitable to my social status and live a life free of pointless desire and pride. Form, beauty, appearance, all are superfluous. Reason dictates that I seek a biological partner who lets me live my life with greater efficiency.
While what she's saying isn't technically wrong, it really... really creeps me out.
even the capital is silent as death.
Innominant's power did all of this. A god among gods.
Fountains are purely decorative and serve no purpose to the collective good of mankind. They must be purged.
Not just the fountains. The streets and houses are filled with unnecessary extravagances. Comfort is another word for vanity. It is a lie that breeds only envy and war. All vanity must be purged.
Yes, we cannot let ourselves be ruled by desire. We must control ourselves and lead lives of purity.
If they keep abandoning desire after desire, eventually they'll abandon even their desire to live.
Isn't there anyone here who still has free thought?
I hope so. There has to be.
Mommy!
That was a child.
Don't show any feelings, dear.
If they spot you, they'll...
Prince Percival! Tabitha!
You're still you!
Demons? In the capital?
No. The molecules.
No escape! Hold stop! Hurricane!
No mercy! Won't that work?
Looks like you're gonna die!
Tabitha, your mind's still your own?
Yes, somehow. But Prince Percival and that girl...
Looks like those Malakim took them away somewhere.
The prince was trying to help us get away. He said that the Abbey was gathering those who still had control of their own will at the villa.
We need to go after the prince and see just what's going on at the villa.
We don't know what sort of defenses they have at the front gate. Let's sneak in through the back.
Good plan. Back into the catacombs, then.
You got it.
So those weren't demons, they were Malakim.
Yes. They were probably ordered to hunt down any humans who still possess free will. Innominant isn't whole, and his oppressive powers are not yet absolute. So he must be using the Malakim to find anyone he missed and process them. Sounds like him.
Process?
Be it a prince, or a little girl.
I wonder if Tabitha's all right.
I don't think she'll be suppressed so easily.
Aye.
She's got more grit than the average soldier.
But even if she resists oppression, if the Abbey finds her...
She'd stand out even more with us. She ran an entire shadow network. Finding a place to hide will be child's play for her.
Maybe she was just pretending to be an old woman.
Huh? But I really loved Tabitha's cooking.
I'm just kidding. You don't run into a woman that tough every day.
She's been living in society's shadows since before we were born. If she heard you were worried, she'd laugh and say you're wasting your time.
Then we should be on our way to the villa.
A channeling circle!
He's eating their will directly!
Okay, Steven!
With an engine like this, it's almost like...
Like we're a bunch of heroes.
Hey, no fair! You were supposed to say, like what?
Just try! Perfect mayhem! What's the next? Yes, thank you. Well, I know I can still feel scared out of my wits, at least.
It's all right now. We'll help you find your mommy, and then
Mommy was executed. They killed her because she stole food to give to me. But that's okay. They had to. Mommy was acting against reason.
So this is the true face of their suppression.
Yes, this is the ideal world sought by Shepherd Artorias. As long as malevolence gave rise to demons, this was the only way. That's why the Kingdom of Midgan consented to his plan. But I will never consent.
A world without sadness, but also without joy. A world without hate, but also without love.
You suppose the whole world's like this now?
No. Even this close to the Empyrean's throne, some here have held on to their free will. Still, we don't have much time.
Right. I can feel Innominant's domain spreading even now. It's incomplete, but it's quickly growing stronger.
Even we might be suppressed if this keeps up, and then it'll be reason o'clock all day long.
Prince, Griffin is doing well.
Good. That's good. I'm happy. Truly. Until now, I thought I was just a tool to serve my country. But when my feelings were being torn from me, I felt myself want something. No, I thought. I don't want this. I don't want to lose who I am. I understand the true horror of this ideal world now. I know it's selfish to put this burden on you, but I beg you, stop all this. Stop Shepherd Artorias.
You said something to me once. A bird that cannot fly is no bird at all. And now I say this to you. People stripped of their feelings can never truly be alive.
Yeah, that's how I used to be.
We're going to defeat Artorias. We're going to make this world one where we can be ourselves. We're doing it for us, not for you.
You've changed, haven't you?
You really have. You used to be a sword wielded by your own hatred. But now, you're in control. You're the one who swings the blade.
Even if I still don't know when to sheathe it.
Don't worry.
When danger comes, I'll be there to protect you.
My, I'm jealous. It must be nice to have a reliable young man like that by your side.
It certainly is. Our Fee's a gallant soul.
Eisen, about Captain Eifried.
I dealt with him. But the Abbey, they stomped all over Eifried's pride to achieve this suppression of theirs. With these hands, I will destroy them.
Then I'm going to be selfish too. And as just another flawed human being, I will offer a humble prayer that you succeed.
Well, I'm pumped. Who wants to go cut our way into this throne of theirs?
We can't just barge in, sword for brains. We gotta prepare.
We stick to the plan. Wake up the four Empyreans and take Innominant's domain away from him.
Artorias said the ceremony wouldn't be complete until the Scarlet Knight.
Will they complete the ceremony first, or will we awaken the Empyreans? It's a gamble.
Well, moping won't get us anywhere. Let's head to Mount Killerhouse.
Right. It's time to suppress the suppression.